Myself Rahul Kumar Mishra from Diplomatic Guru YouTube channel. Today I once again before you to discuss an important point about the leadership in the BJP. As we know, these Vidhan Sabha election has been completed in 5 states. In these 5 states, in the 3 states, BJP has come into the power. But BJP snatched Rajasthan and Chhattisgarh from the Congress, and in Madhya Pradesh, BJP government was to continue. But in these 3 states, Bharatiya Janata Party replaced its chief ministers. At the place of the Vasundhara Raja Sindhia in Rajasthan, Bharatiya Janata Party chooses Bhajan Lal Sarma as a chief minister. In Chhattisgarh, at the place of the Raman Singh, BJP chooses the Vishnu Dev Sao as a chief minister. Or in Madhya Pradesh, Shivraj Singh Chauhan was the chief minister of the Madhya Pradesh since 20 years, but he was also replaced by the BJP. At his place, Dr. Mohan Yadav became the chief minister of the Madhya Pradesh. And what is the benefit of the BJP to replace these chief ministers? The only benefit is that BJP, whenever it wants to replace the chief minister in these 3 states, there is no any contradiction. There is no anything that will be going on against the BJP leadership. So there is nobody, and these 3 leaders, Bhajan Lal Sarma, Dr. Mohan Yadav and Vishnu Dev Sai, these are the loyal for the party if party removed him from the CMship. So this is the biggest profit for the Bharatiya Janata Party as a central leadership. And as we know, if we are talking about the central leadership after Modi, in 2024 election was contested by the BJP party at the face of the PM Narendra Modi. But it was the third term, it will be the third term for the PM Modi. And after that, as per the rule of the Bharatiya Janata Party, whoever crossed the 75 years, that would be go into the Margdarshan Committee. And Modi will also go to the Margdarshan Committee. Then what to do the successor of the Modi? If we are talking about the successor of the Modi, then after we can find 2 names. That 2 names will be the face of the Modi's successor. The first one is the Yogi Adityanath, the Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister, and second one is the Amit Shah, the Home Minister of the India. If we are talking about the Yogi Adityanath, Yogi Adityanath as a popularity, and he ruled over the heart of the people, especially in Uttar Pradesh and North India. In all over the India, he ruled over the heart of the people. But he has lack of the experience of the to run the government. This is the disqualification of the Yogi ji. But Yogi's work, it is a very tremendous work, especially in the UP. And in the popularity, Yogi Adityanath is much ahead of the Amit Shah as a successor of the PM Modi. And if we are talking about the Amit Shah is, when he was the small activist, not a big leader at that time, then he became the Home Minister of the Gujarat. After that, in 2014, Modi has given an opportunity to Amit Shah in Uttar Pradesh to win the most of the seats in the Lok Sabha. But Amit Shah delivered very well. BJP won more than 75 seats of the Lok Sabha in 2014 Lok Sabha election. And after that, he became the national president of the Bharatiya Janata Party. And as a national president of the Bharatiya Janata Party, his style of the working to strengthen the party, to extend the Bharatiya Janata Party, that will be very tremendous way. In the 7 sister states, Nagaland, Mizoram, Manipur, these Assam, these are the states where BJP never exist. But now the most of the states has a BJP leadership. This was the miracle done by the Amit Shah. And as a Home Minister of the India from 2019, he brought CAA, and then after, as we know, Article 370 and 35A also removed by the Amit Shah under the leadership of the PM Narendra Modi. So it will be very interesting, and it will be the very tough for the बीजेपी सेंट्रल लीडरशिप एंड आरएसएस टू राष्ट्रीय स्वयंसेवक संघ टू हु विल बी द सक्सेसर ऑफ द पीएम नरेंद्र मोदी इट विल बी योगी आदित्यनाथ आर अमित शाह। अमित शाह हैज मच बेटर पर्सन मच बेटर एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव क्वालिटी टू रन द गवर्नमेंट इट विल बी अहेड ऑफ द योगी आदित्यनाथ।